Welcome to our first vlog from NRF 2017. We're sharing with you our top technology highlights from the show today. Now, we've really seen three key things today coming through. And that the first one is all around cognitive computing, particularly IBM's use of Watson. The second one is the use of augmented reality, and we've seen this through your Samsung VR headsets or your HoloLens. And then the third one is wearables, and wearables with the connectedness of contactless payment technology. So the rest of this vlog will show you more. So one of the uses of Watson we've seen today is integrated with the car. It started to learn about your journeys as a driver of the car, where you go, where you might shop, and therefore retailers can start to send you personalised offer based on your routes that you might take. Also then when you've placed an order, they can start to get that ready because they know your location, they know where you are. So again, it's all about learning about your journey, looking about all the analytics and how you can gain traction from retailing within that.
And now today we're talking about General Motors and IBM. We have partnered together with the OnStar system. We're launching OnStar Go. This is an engagement platform for retailers and brands to essentially, you know, grab that time with consumers. Instead of being stuck in traffic, we're turning that into time well spent. We've got a variety of things that we're doing. We're pushing promotions into the vehicle that are contextually aware, for example, depending on the weather, depending on your location, depending on your routine. We also get into specialized workflow. So we're here at NRF for retail, one of the top use cases that we're doing for folks, so along the lines of store pickup, curbside pickup, integrating with order management systems, where the vehicle really becomes another endpoint in the story of order fulfillment. Okay.
This is all using IBM Watson technology.
Yes, and then we have IBM Watson at the very top of the stack, which provides a level of cognition and personalization, and again, bringing in the reality of that experience, right? What is the consumer doing? What are they trying to achieve? How can the brand integrate into that routine and provide value?
We've seen lots of companies in the analytics space today, and the key driver of this is really around the personalization of message for your customer. Retailers are really trying to understand what customers want, what they're interested in, and send them promotions or messaging which is really aligned to things that they will be interested in. So here's some of that in action.
We go to Ireland already, let me watch.
So what I'm doing now, again, I'm taking these data entry points.
Sure.
And this is a rough UI, but I'm kind of visualizing how we create personalized messages for you based on the inputs that you just gave me. So think of a customer, again, you're in your living room and a retailer might have thousands of touch points. We're using that, it's generating a personalized offer just for you. It'll materialize in terms of a text message, an email, or a video in this case. You'll see it here, a video. We used Alaska, not Banff, so anyway. So great, you're going to Alaska. It looks like your wardrobe. You picked the stripes, right? Well, this kind of mixed. Here we go. So what it's doing, basically, this is a personalized video. Now you're saying, okay, we've got 10% off this jacket because you're going skiing, right? So why don't you come into the store or buy it online? So it's, again, key message here is personalized messaging based on customer inputs online. Okay. No longer will.
One of the interesting things we've seen at the show is the integration of payment technology with wearables. Now, we've seen some wristbands developed by Visa. They actually use these at the Olympic Village, and Olympians were using them to charge things around the village and pay for things. They've integrated that technology into watches as well, so they can be used for payments. Now, interestingly, the next thing they've generated is the use of a ceramic ring. And the same thing, you can preload the ring with payment and then use that to charge that for items that you might want to purchase. Now that might be handy if you're out on a run or you don't want to carry your phone or your wallet with you, but again, it's integrating that wearable tech with contactless payment. Here's it in action.
That is coming in spring is our ring, and it is ceramic, it is waterproof, and it does not need to be charged. It actually gets its charge off of your blood running through your veins. So that's a nice thing, and it works on any digital wallet area that you can go to. So any store that uses a digital wallet now should work with the ring.
Right.
it'd be more for smaller purchases.
Yeah.
So you could go into, you know, a store and get like some groceries and say it costs you, make sure it's on there, $10. So that's what the cashier would do. And then it would say, can you, you know, give us your payment?
Yeah.
You would knock.
Knock on that.
And then it goes through. Yeah.
Have you rolled this out?
Thanks for watching our first vlog. There'll be more tomorrow, so watch again and search Retail Assist on YouTube or online.